Hey guys, Jen here. Just trying to get the volume on this thing, hopefully. Welcome to the live stream. So today is episode 4 of Live with Jen B, and today we're talking story TV. So each day I'm doing these live streams during the week, and there's different topics. So today we're talking, like I said, story TV, which is all about craft. So it's the craft of writing fiction, writing novels, that kind of thing. And today I wanted to talk about stakes. So I work with a lot of writers. I work with, lots and lots of writers all year long, and I see them in workshops. I see them as private coaching, and then I just see writers in general because, I'm in the writing world and I spend a lot of time with writers. And the biggest thing that I see with stories is that there's no stakes or there's nothing at stake. So a lot of the, I would say the issues that I see in people's stories, and especially when, they haven't done any planning or hadn't really thought about the story ahead of time, but they kind of just sat down and started writing, is that they don't have any stakes, or the stakes are extremely low. So this is a really important thing to keep in mind when you're creating a story, when you're coming up with, who your characters are and, what the journey is going to be and all of that. It's really important to keep in mind that your protagonist, this person who's going to become heroic over the course of the story by overcoming an inner demon, overcoming an antagonist, and actually achieving something, hopefully the goal they had at the beginning of the story, but if not, some other goal to supplement not achieving that goal. And along the way, there's got to be something at stake for them. So the biggest thing that I see is that there'll be stakes that have to do with like the bigger, let's say the world, the guy's got to save the world or something like that, which is fine because that is something at stake. But the problem is that there's nothing personal at stake. And so I think the best stories are always the ones where the antagonist causes the protagonist to have something personal at stake. So whether that's, a love interest or it's a relationship with a family member or, just something in their life that they're going to lose by not doing whatever it is that they are now having to do because of the antagonist, or the antagonist sort of just brings that extra layer of something there that's going to cause this character to now have to do whatever the journey is. And I say that, the whole stakes thing is something that I see very often that people don't really have in their stories, and I think it's just because we don't realize a lot of the times that there aren't stakes. So, and we're going to do a couple of exercises on here today to just help you figure out, if your story does have stakes, and if not, let's put some there. So, as an example, as you know, examples are always the easiest way to understand what's at stake. So, let's say the story that I wrote, okay, so sound check the, and you may not have read it, but if you have, then you will understand the story. But the idea is, okay, this character in the beginning, the protagonist, she wants to achieve this goal of getting this promotion. It's her dream job. It's the thing she's always wanted. She's been working toward it for a long time now, and that's what she wants. But at the first plot point, what happens is the introduction of the antagonist, which of course gives us actual stakes. So before this happens, before the introduction of the antagonist, the character is just in her day-to-day life doing her thing. And yeah, like her dream job is at stake because she's working toward it. But there's nothing really personal about it until the antagonist comes in. And then suddenly the stakes get raised like a million times because now she gets an ultimatum that's going to cause her to be having something in the way of her getting this dream job. So at the beginning of the story, she's not worried about it. She thinks she's a shoo-in. It's going to happen without a problem. She doesn't have to worry about it. And then when the antagonist gets introduced, suddenly the dream job is sort of taken away from her, and all these other things come into play, and it's like you have to do all this other stuff before you can achieve that now. And so now the stakes have been completely raised for her, and in a much more personal way, because this is something that she's wanted for such a long time. And and also it ties into like a love relationship and things that are in the story, but the idea is it's raising the stakes on what's already in play. So the first thing I would say is thinking about the story you're currently working on, and if you're not working on a story, then think about one you've been thinking about and maybe haven't just written yet, but maybe you've been thinking about it. But the first question I would say is just ask yourself, what is at stake in this story? So, a lot of the times you're gonna find that there really isn't anything. And if you have something that's sort of a bigger picture type of a thing, like, oh, the guy's gonna save the world, so what's at stake is his life or the lives of all these people, which is a good stakes. I mean, that's good stakes, but you want something that's more personal to the character. So that way, it feels like something the reader wants to root for them for. Like, yeah, the reader's gonna root for this guy to, save the world and overcome, the bad guy so that the world can be saved. Yeah, they're gonna root for that. But if you put something more personal into the mix, they're gonna root for it even more. So, like, I like to look at Spider-Man as an example. So, the movie Spider-Man, and in that one, in the first one, he has obviously knows that he has to defeat the bad guy and he has to
help save the, you know, New York City and all that. But it gets much more personal for him stakes-wise when the antagonist kidnaps his love interest, Mary Jane, and basically makes it so that, you know, he has to choose between rescuing her and rescuing all these people who are being, you know, dangled over this bridge. So that raised the stakes completely. And so that's what actually keeps the momentum going in the story. It's what keeps the conflict going in the story. And a lot of stories that I, you know, see in my work that I do and that I just see writers putting out there, they don't have that stakes. They don't have something in there that's going to really make the readers want to root for this character, want to see them actually be heroic and overcome the bad guys. So if you don't currently have stakes in your story, then this is the time to actually start thinking about it. So like I said, your first question is, what is at stake in my story? And it may not be enough. So that's the whole thing. It's more just looking at, do you even have anything? So maybe you may have something, that's great. But is there a way to raise the stakes a little bit? So that would be your second question now, is to think about, okay, so let's say there is something at stake. Well, how can we raise the stakes a little bit? What can we do to make it even more personal, to make it even more, you know, just conflicted, and so that this character has even more that he has to do this for? Because the whole idea of this character becoming heroic and going on this journey in the story is that he has to have something that he's doing it for, which is the stakes. So if there was nothing at stake, then there would really be no reason for the character to overcome the antagonist, overcome the inner demon, so that he can get to the end of the story and be the hero, because he wouldn't have anything at stake for him. He wouldn't even care. It wouldn't matter. So the stakes actually make the journey matter and make the actual plot of the story matter. So definitely be thinking about anytime you're working on a story, but especially if you're working on one that you have written already or that you are revising, big thing to think about is, do I have enough at stake? Is there enough here that the reader is going to want to follow this journey? They're going to want to root for this character to actually achieve what he wants to achieve and to, you know, overcome the bad guy so that he can stake claim to these stakes that he's got that he maybe doesn't have right now. So again, it's all going to be different for every story. So the bigger thing is to just look at the fact of, do I have stakes in my story? And then if you do, that's great. But then think about, how can you, you know, amp the stakes up completely by adding something more personal or tweaking it a little bit so that it feels like there's something even bigger going on besides just what you had currently. Now, if you don't have any stakes, now is the time to say, okay, what could I add to the story that would be more personal for this character, that would cause them to have even more of a reason to go on this journey, defeat the antagonist, and, you know, become the hero at the end of the story? So that is just one of many things that I see fiction writers having errors on in their stories. But stakes is a really big part of it, because if you don't have anything at stake, no one cares about the story. The stakes are what make the story interesting and what make the reader actually want to read the story, is knowing that there's something this character could potentially lose or have taken away from them or never achieve because of the antagonist. And so because of that, you're like, yes, I'm on board, I want to see what happens. But when there's nothing at stake, you're kind of just like, what is the point of this? Like, why am I even reading this? Like, it doesn't make sense. So if you saw a movie where there was nothing at stake, you probably would walk out because you wouldn't be interested in the story. It wouldn't have engaged you. And it definitely wouldn't have the pacing that it needs, because there'd be nothing at play. There'd be nothing there that the character is trying to save or trying to get back or trying to overcome. It would just be a journey of an episodic, you know, day-to-day life of a character, which is another issue that writers have. And we'll talk about that in a future episode of Story TV. But today, just to stay focused on stakes, we won't get into all of that. So yeah, so your two questions for today, for your, you know, just while you are working on your next story, or if you're working on a story right now, number one is, what is at stake in the story? Number two is, and this is only if number one actually has stakes, number two is, how can I raise the stakes? Now, if you don't have any stakes, then of course it's, how can I add stakes to the story that are going to actually be personal to the character? So that is my little rant on stakes. That is something I see a lot of writers missing in their stories, and I think that it's a huge, huge mistake, because you're not giving the reader something to, you know, kind of clutch into and like want to actually be part of this journey. They're just kind of like, eh, okay, whatever. But if you put something at stake, suddenly you care. You care if Peter Parker saves Mary Jane. You care if he saves the people in the tram too, but you especially care about him saving Mary Jane because you know how much he cares about her and how much he's in love with her. And so that keeps you wanting to pay attention to the story and wanting to see what happens. So that's why stakes are super important. So if anyone has any questions, put them in now. Otherwise, I'm going to wrap this up. And like I said, Thursdays is Story TV. So every Thursday, my live streams will be a piece of craft talking about something really important that you should have in your story. And just giving you the big picture of what it takes to write a really good story. Now, that could be novel, it could be short story, it could be screenplay. Anything that you're doing that's fiction, this would play into that. So, and actually, it would really work for memoir, too. I've noticed over the last few years that you actually see a lot of the times that memoirs that are really successful have some of that story structure type of a thing built into it. So you actually see, like, what was at stake for this person? So even though it was nonfiction, hey, how are you? Good to see you on here. But yeah, so it basically, I just lost my train of thought because one of my friends that I haven't talked to in a long time just popped in. So in a memoir, I've seen that like a lot of the times you can use the same principles of story structure, of stakes, to actually make your memoir better, because you're looking at, okay, what was that stake for me when I was in this, you know, time in my life, or what was that stake for me when I was going through whatever, you know, transformation you're writing about in the memoir. And so from there, you can actually use this stuff to make your memoir better. Now, that's not to say to make it fake or to make up stuff, but you can actually use the idea of like, okay, you know, what was the antagonist that I was dealing with, and what was the, and this kind of goes off the topic of stakes, but I'm just sort of jiving on this because it kind of just came to me. But it's the idea that like you can apply this fictional principles of storytelling to other things, and it actually helps them to come to life more because you're using the elements of good storytelling. So even if it's a memoir, even if it's something nonfiction, you actually still have, you know, there's still stakes, there's still an antagonist, there's still a journey that the character is going to go on. They're going to become a hero, or they're going to overcome something. So it works in fiction and it works in nonfiction. So again, just to go over the two questions for anyone who's just hopping in, if you are working on a story and you want to make it better, make it more conflicted, and just give the reader something even more to dig into, figure out, number one, what's at stake in this story? Is it personal enough? So if it's not, make sure you make it more personal to the protagonist so that it makes it something that the reader actually wants to follow this character and see how it comes out and, you know, see how it plays out. Number two is, if there aren't any stakes, what can you do to add some? And if you already have stakes, what can you do to raise the stakes? So that is what I have for you today. Thank you for joining the live stream. And if you are working on a story right now, whether you've started a first draft or whether you are working on a revision of a novel and you want to just get that damn thing finished, you've been sitting on it, you're sick of it, you don't want to look at it anymore, you're just ready to get it written, get it done so you can move on to the next step, then be sure to check out my upcoming workshop, Finish Your Damn Novel. It starts on Saturday, April 1st, so in a couple of days. And we are going to hit the ground running with 30 days of just getting our writing done, getting the draft done, working on the revisions, and so that by the end of the month, you have all the stuff that you've been doing adding up to a finished draft or a finished revision so that you can, on May 1st, move to the next step. So I'm actually revising my novel in the workshop along with you. And so my goal is May 1st to get it in the hands of my editor, get in the hands of beta readers, so that I can move on to the screenplay that I've been dying to write for a really long time now. But I won't do that until I finish this draft. And it's really, really important, and I would say a key thing to keep in mind is that if you are a writer and you want to be a professional, you have to learn how to finish. And finishing, which means actually not just starting something, but going all the way and finishing it, is a thing that you have to practice, because it doesn't just come naturally. Now, some people are really good at finishing. They start stuff, they finish it, it's no problem. But I think a lot of writers, and especially multi-passionate writers, so writers like me, who just have lots of different things that you want to do, you have to, you know, really think about becoming a finisher, because otherwise you'll end up starting all this stuff and never finishing any of it. So that actually stops you from getting to the next step and, of course, going to the next level with your writing, you know, your writing career and all of that. So this workshop is going to totally help you become a finisher. You're going to get daily emails that are motivating you. You're going to get just live streams in the Facebook group. So we have a private Facebook group so that I'm going to be motivating you and inspiring you to keep going. And, of course, helping you troubleshoot any challenges that you have along the way. I'm going to be sharing my journey as I revise my story, and I would love to have you join us. So go to jenniferblanchard.net/finishyourdamnnovel to check the workshop out, and I will catch you next time.